It covers the lives of four generations in a village family. And in the beginning of the film, the first generation, the oldest man, he dies. His name is Century Gowda. He's 101. He's very cranky. And he dies. And then the film follows the lives of his son, his grandson, and his great-grandson over 11 days, up to his tithi, which is the title of the film. It's just a film that's very open and true and honest and about life. But I think the best way to sort of term it is it's a playful film. The film's screenplay actually came quite a bit after the initial idea to make this film. So we decided to make this film when about 5 years ago, when for the first time I went to the village of the writer who I wrote with, Ire Gowda, who's been a friend of mine since I was young. So I've known him since sixth grade, so for many years, before I'd actually gone to see his village. And when I went to see his village, we had already done some, I'd done some short films, and he was involved with those films, and we had this great relationship. We knew each other like really well. So I went there and I was like, I was interested in the world, and of course he had such a special relationship with the place because he was from there. So I very casually said, shall we make a film here? And he's like, sure. You know, it was as casual as that, and it ended up sticking as an idea that we stuck with for the next, you know, few years. And after that idea was born, I went to film school after that to prepare myself to make this film. So to get technical enough to be able to handle this film. We wanted like the story to be born organically from that place and the interactions of that place. In that period where we went and stayed with him, where we went and stayed in the village and explored, we were basically searching for any interesting people, any interesting events, any interesting locations. Basically all the actors are from there. The language is very, very particular to that region because that's the dialect that they speak. And it's a beautiful dialect of Kannada. Like, it sounds really musical. Place is important in creating the sort of world, or like, you know, the base on which we've filled it with universal characters. So it's the flavor. It's the flavor of the film is the place. We were also kind of keen on casting the main actors before we thought of the story itself, because we felt that the key ingredient of this film would be eventually performance. How believable these actors are on screen. How true to character, how true to life, how alive are they? So that's quite complex. And so a lot of the filmmaking was built around making them be able to become these characters that we were thinking of. So doing that with non-professionals is not always easy. So we wanted to cast our leads before and then write for them, which is quite unorthodox in the filmmaking process in general. So the three main actors, the three generations, not the man who dies, but the three generations under him, the three sort of heroes of this film, were cast first. Then we started writing, using all that stuff we had collected. And people have come from different places. So there was myself from a certain background, my co-writer from another background, Ire Gowda, then my DOP, Doron Tempert, he's from Holland, my editor's from the US, my sound designer's from Kerala. So we came together from all over the place. That helped create a sort of fresh voice. I think that has helped the film break out in certain ways. Like from our premiere onwards in Locarno, where we won, we ended up going to so many festivals, having incredible experiences. The film was watched by Francis Ford Coppola, the director of The Godfather, and he loved it. So we've had these incredible opportunities. We've screened in the Museum of Modern Art in New York, which is again a huge, huge honor for our film. So the film has been recognized at many levels. But to be recognized by the government in home country is really, really special. And what I think was really exciting for us this year is that a lot of the awards went to bigger productions, like sort of big budget commercial films that were studio developed and were released across the country to major commercial acclaim. So that in a way was, I guess, the vision of the jury was awarding larger films this year in particular. So for that jury to award us as well, I'm hoping that's pointing to some commercial potential. I mean, we always built this film as artists, you know, with art in mind, but the film is sort of growing organically to have a much, much wider commercial potential than we ever imagined. So it's releasing in May, the first half of May. The exact date we're going to be releasing soon, and we're really confident about how the Indian audience is going to react, because we screened in, for example, the Bangalore International Film Festival, which is the local audience, where we had like an incredibly positive response. And like for our third screening, we had a line that was 3 times the capacity of the theater. Like, so if we had like 300 seats, the line was almost 900 long. So that shows that there's a demand for alternate content, content that's maybe packaged in a different way, content that's fresh and maybe using some of the more international styles of cinema as a language to portray its story. In Karnataka, across India, there will be new voices coming out with things that they want to say, like honestly, without, you know, the involvement of, say, like massive studios, without having to stick to templates. So I really see cinema growing from strength to strength. And I think, yeah, of course, different states are at different levels of evolution of this. Bengali cinema has always had an art house culture. Marathi cinema has always had that. And it's there and it's already thriving. Maybe we're a little bit more nascent in that, but it's happening, and it's going to happen, and it's going to grow very quickly.